We want to take a minute to look at how one program is using music to help seniors relive some memories from the past.
I love this idea. It comes from a charity called Room 217, which educates caregivers on how to use music that helps seniors. Tomorrow, that foundation is bringing the idea to the stage with a concert they've called Voices That Care. Joining us now is the architect of the show, singer and songwriter Murray McLauchlan. Welcome to your morning.
Thank you very much. It's nice to be here.
I love this idea. Explain to us the thought behind it, this music care approach for seniors.
Well, anyone who's been a fan of Oliver Sacks, the late great, understands that music is stored in a different part of the brain, not in the part where conscious memory or speech or those kinds of things exist. So it's really the last thing to go when people are suffering from dementia, from Alzheimer's or dementia. So our singing program, which is called Pathways, is called that precisely because it can recreate paths back to your sense of who you are. And it's very reassuring sometimes for people who have been in the process of losing themselves. It's quite a frightening thing. So our singing program goes into adult daycare centers. That's what it's for. That's what this initiative is for. And these are places where they don't really have funding for programs, where people will just park their loved one or their relative for the afternoon so they can get some shopping done or just take a breath or have a break. The people who work there, the caregivers who work in these places, love the program because it's a group program. And when people sing in a group, as they do with this, it releases oxytocin, the birthing chemical. There's bonding, there's elevation of mood, there's decrease of isolation, there is an obviation of, you know, aberrant behavior, so thus not so much in the way of medications are required, et cetera, et cetera. And we have all of this really coming back to us now, not just anecdotally, but clinically. So it's a very, very powerful tool for the medical profession and for caregivers.
So, Murray, talk to us about this concert then, Voices That Care. What was the effect of something like this?
Well, it's what it sounds like. It's a fundraiser, but it's fun. The idea is, you know, I'm not going to be standing up there on the stage with a bunch of people preaching or shaking anybody by the heels for money. People have, you know, corporations and private donors have been very, very generous with us to fund this program. All I want to do is basically give them a really good show, and everybody's going to walk out like a little higher than they walked in. Sure. But it's, you know, they're great people. Dan Hill is coming. You might remember Dan Hill. Mm-hmm. Most people would from, you know, his huge hit records. Sylvia Tyson of Ian and Sylvia fame, but very much on her own person. On the new front, Ezra Jordan, who was huge on the launch, I think you might remember.
Right.
And was also the son of Mark Jordan and Amy Sky. Secret comedian who I can't talk about.
Ooh, okay.
And no, we're not channeling any demised comedians through transmediums or anything like that. But it's a really, really interesting cast. I will play, of course, myself. Mm. I keep forgetting that. Like, I'll be doing that, too. But, you know, it's not for the greater glory of moi. It's just going to be a good show. It'll be fun.
Murray, it sounds like such a great idea. Okay. And we were talking about it before. It sounds like lightning in a bottle. Once you tell people about it, it sounds like, of course, what a great idea. So thank you so much for this. And we should tell our viewers that if you're in the Toronto area, Voices That Care benefit concert takes place tomorrow night. So again, thank you very much, sir. We appreciate your time.
Well, thank you for the time and the help. I appreciate it very much.
Absolutely.